Welcome back to Changwon, South Korea, here at the Changwon International Shooting Range. It's the 52nd ISSF World Championship, and it is the final day. We've got the penultimate final on a cloudy, drizzly day here in Changwon. It's the Skeet Women's Junior Final. My name is Jamie Sangroom, and I am joined by Esme van der Veen of the Netherlands. Skeet shooter, how are you, Esme?
I'm really good. How are you?
I'm doing good. I'm just happy to be in your presence. It's very good to have you here as a guest. You were highly recommended by my colleague Danny Potts. I believe you joined him.
Gentlemen, please welcome our athletes to the race.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah.
So this is your second time.
Second time.
Welcome back. So we've got our six finalists out there in front of you now, and our announcer here in Changwon is Rory McAllister.
The 52nd ISSF World Championship, Changwon
right
2018.
Now, so let's hand over to
Rory. International Shooting Sport Federation.
We'll talk more
welcome
after,
you to
Esme.
The Changwon
Work's not done.
International
we'll talk after
Shooting
the presentation,
range.
Okay? Don't leave.
The
please.
Final competition for the Skeet Women Junior event will now begin. At position number one, representing the United States of America, she won a world championship bronze medalist as a junior in Moscow 2017, Samantha Simonton.
So she's back again in her second world championship final.
At position number two, representing the People's Republic of China, she won a world championship gold as a junior in Lonato 2015 and a silver medalist at the Junior World Cup Sydney 2018 and Porpeto 2017. Xie Yufei.
Also took a bronze medal at this summer's Seoul Junior World Cup. So 19-year-old's already got.
At position number three, representing the People's Republic of China, in her first world championship final after finishing fifth at the Junior World Cup Porpeto 2017 and seventh in Sydney 2018. It's Song Chongyi.
Her debut appearance in a final at a world championship.
At position number four, representing the People's Republic of China, she was sixth in the Junior World Cup in Sydney this year, 2018. Sun Yashu.
And appearing at her first ever world championship, making it straight into a final, not bad.
And at position number five, representing the United States of America, a world championship silver as a junior in Moscow last year, 2017, Austin Smith.
So it's our second medalist from this final in Moscow last year, appearing in this final.
And at position at number six, USA, representing the Russian Federation, in her first world championship and first final, Elizaveta Egrafova.
Did compete in Seoul this summer at the Junior World
the
Cup.
The jury
that's
member
first,
in charge of this final is Choi Hyung-ju from the Republic
second.
Of Korea.
So here come the officials in charge of this final.
And the referee for this final is Jong Sung Ho from the Republic of Korea.
So we've met our finalists, we've met our jury, we've met our referee.
Ladies and gentlemen, encourage the athletes
so Esme,
at all times. And please
is this
enjoy
your first
the final.
Time in Changwon? Were you here for the World Cup in April?
No, and I didn't went here for the World Cup.
So this is your first time?
Yeah, first time in Korea. Yeah.
But not your first World Championship. You've appeared at four, we're thinking here?
Yeah.
Four?
So yeah.
It seems like you've lost count. We were chatting before we came on there.
I think it's my sixth year in the Dutch team, so I've lost count to everywhere I've been.
Yeah, well, we know for sure. We were trying to work it out before we came on air. You were definitely in Moscow last year.
Yeah.
Obviously here in Changwon now and in Lonato.
Yeah,
as well.
Lonato,
so they're
yeah.
three of the four. There's a mystery world championship appearance out there. And I should mention as well that you are the current record holder, aren't you?
Yeah, yeah.
So tell me about that.
Last month at Austria, the European Championships, I shot a qualification world record and a new European record with 118.
Wow.
So yeah, that was pretty cool. I went in final as first and finished fifth. Nerves.
So, well, yeah, but I mean, you can still take away those two accolades you mentioned, and of course, making a final anyway is always,
yeah.
always a great achievement. So, European world record, European world record, that's weird. European record, yeah.
Yeah.
And qualifying record.
Yeah. Yeah, qualifying world record. Yeah.
World record, wow.
With the woman junior.
So you were keeping a close eye on the qualifying for this, were you? Just to make sure no one bettered it.
No, no one bettered it. I shot 117 at highest qualification, so my world record stands for a whole year. I hope.
Yeah, well, I hope for you as well. And how did your qualifying go today?
Yesterday, it was not my day. I can say it was not my day. And today I thought about it, I accepted, and I thought I'm just going to have fun. And I shot 48 out of 50, so that was really good. Yeah, I was really happy with my end result, and I ended 11. So
how's your World Championships in Changwon experience been overall?
Really good. We had a nice hotel, buses were great, people are great, food.
It's not for
really
you.
My thing, the noodles and the stuff.
The kimchi?
No, no, not really.
Barbecue? You had a Korean barbecue?
No, we most of the time eat Burger King.
Oh,
it's so bad. But it was the nicest thing to eat, like around, and then we found a steakhouse. So after the Burger King, we went there. It was better.
Okay. All right, you're off the hook. And if you are new to this event at home, we're going to have 6 targets in total. And the eliminations will begin after 20. So our athletes are doing cycles. So they stop at station 3, station 4, station 5. So we're currently at station 3, where they have 4 targets, so 2 pairs each. And then there's 1 pair, 4, and then 4 targets, 2 pairs at station 5. After 20 targets, the first elimination will take place. And that will continue after every 10 until our medals have been decided. So the gold and silver after 60. Now, if we have a tiebreak situation for any of those eliminations, if it's before the medals, that elimination will come down to bib number. So Samantha Simonton of USA, she has got the best bib number there. And our Russian shooter, Evgravova, has the weakest bib number. So that would come into play to settle a tiebreak situation. But, correct me if I'm wrong, for the gold medal, doesn't matter. If we have a tie break, we have a good old-fashioned shoot-off, don't we?
It's really
so
exciting.
Samantha Simonson scoring three, the rest of the athletes all on four.
You do? It's easy to say as a spectator, I guess.
Yeah,
if you're out there,
you don't want anyone to be as good as you are. But.
And it was a perfect start at station 4 for 5 of our finalists. All hitting 4. Simonton the only one to hit 3. But she's far from it. The early days. All two there. And what about the weather? I mean, it's stopped raining now, more or less, but it's been very wet for you skeet shooters, hasn't it?
Yeah, it was awful. But it's just the same as Holland, so I don't have, like, anything to... Yeah. To say that I didn't like it, we have the same weather in Holland, so it's just normal for us. Like, if we have sun, it's, like, really great.
Mm.
But if it's raining, we don't care.
Yeah, pretty similar to the UK as well, where I'm from. But the rain has stopped. What do you think to these conditions right now for those finalists out there? We've got some low cloud. I don't know if that matters, but there's no breeze.
I think the weather is good. You don't have wind, so it's good for targets. And yeah, the weather is nice. Nice is it? If it's not raining, then it's okay. Then it's good.
Yeah, we had a wet start to the championships. We've been here a long time. I think I've seen all the seasons. So I feel like I've lived a big chunk of my life here in Changwon.
Yeah.
Been here since the 28th of August. The competition started on the 31st, and it was a wet start for the trap. And then kind of got sunny and nice for a while. And then as soon as you skeet people turn up, the rain starts to fall.
Yeah, it's the same.
We have already.
So,
there's only one target.
Nobody missed.
Missed
at station 4.
Shooters all tied on 6.
You're my eyes on the scoreboard, which is far away from us. Can you confirm nobody missed?
Just
one miss all final
Samantha
so
missed.
Far.
Yeah,
that was at station 3, wasn't it?
Yeah, 3-4, and nobody missed.
So it's going to be a tight one, isn't it, by the looks of it?
Yeah, I hope so. It makes it exciting. So.
What do you know about any of the shooters out there? Do any of you know personally?
Some of them. I saw the Americans last year, so I know they were like really good shooters. The Chinese I saw this year in Sydney, so I already get to know them a little, but they like don't speak English that good.
Yeah.
So it's like really hard to communicate, and we like kick football together, but that was about it.
Yeah, you can always communicate via a football with anyone on planet Earth. Yeah, I'd really like to have, obviously, you're my number one, Esme, but I'd really like to have a Chinese shooter as a guest because they're good. They're good at the sport and the pistol as well. They're, you know, they clear up the medals quite often, but it's the language barrier. It would be an awkward broadcasting experience. But one day, we're going to work on it. We're going to work on it.
I hope for you it works out.
Thank you, Esme. Thank you.
But they're really nice people if you like get to know them a little, like with sign language and,
yeah.
and stuff. They're really nice, but yeah.
Yeah, and the ones who do speak English, the Chinese team are very, very friendly, very helpful. As well, they help me with the pronunciations of the names when I have to announce them in front of people, which is
quite a
scary prospect when you look at the names on paper, but they make it easy for me.
That's so nice.
As does my colleague Shaq, our commentator for the men's skeet final.
We had a miss.
We haven't had many misses this final, so that's our second miss now.
Yeah.
And that was for Song. Two misses.
Yeah.
I'm glad you reverted my attention back to what's actually happening out there. I was on one then. I don't know what I was talking about.
Yeah, I was going to watch a final with my coach, but when you ask me, I would love to be here, so.
Yeah.
I have to keep watching. So.
You do. That's the job. That's the job as a co-commentator. You've got to make my life as easy as possible. You know? Read the scoreboard for me, the scoreboard that I can't see.
Oh, we had a double miss.
So after that really clean start all round, there's a few misses now on the table.
Yeah, first 20 targets are the most important targets there are because they like already make a little of which place you're going to get. So.
And we're about to complete our first 10, so halfway to that 20 that has been mentioned, and that is when our first elimination will take place. Well, so sixth place will go after 20 targets. Two hits for Smith there.
Yeah, she only missed the high one on the first double.
Yeah, so three in total at this station. There. And these are our final four now, before we go back again.
Oh, she's going to claim it.
Let's see what the result is.
I don't think she's going to get it. It was definitely a miss.
Looks like the people in charge would agree with you. The scoreboard's not been updated, but I think we're about to have the answer. Just waiting for the referees to have their discussions.
I didn't see a piece, so.
So you're saying it's a miss?
Yeah, I think it's a miss.
Let's see what the referees say. Long wait. Are moments like this quite distracting when you're out there? Sort of breaking the pace?
Yeah, because always someone tries to claim a target. I don't think she's going to get it.
The scoreboard's not been updated. It's still a miss on the scoreboard, so looks like she's about to shoot again. So it looks like you were right. I listened to you.
Yeah. It's always someone who's trying to claim a target, so. Yeah, it's also distracting for herself, so I don't know why. Like, if it's really peace, then more people would see it.
Yeah, you'd hear from the crowd, wouldn't you?
Yeah.
Obvious wrong decision made. So you can see that cloud we talked about, and you can see the table as well. A few more misses now, as we mentioned. Halfway towards our first elimination, it's Jet Yufei of China leading the way with 10 hits to her name, so the only one to hit all her targets in the end there. So now it's really where you start thinking about your score and where you are on the table, isn't it?
Yeah. But Xie Yufei is really good. It will be a hard one for the Americans, but they're also really good. Everyone here is good. They're all trained so much, so. It's three.
Another miss for Simonton, but you mentioned the Americans. They've both got experience in one of these finals at a world championship, both taking a medal away from Moscow just last year.
Yeah, Last year I thought 1, 2, and 3 were all American girls.
Yes, it was Monica Davis as well, wasn't it? Took the gold.
Yeah, this year she didn't make it. Thought she would, but with a Russian girl, it's also exciting to have another one for American and Chinese.
Yeah, it mixes it up a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, Katerina Monica Jacob, who we were talking about there, looking to defend her junior gold medal from Moscow, finished in 7th place in
she lost
in the
shoot off. Yeah.
Down to a shoot off. That's the coolest way to miss out, isn't it, I suppose?
Yeah.
Song. 3 Chinese shooters in this final, 2 Americans, 1 Russian.
Oh.
Two hits for Sun there. Another 2, 12 out of 14. That's our 3rd shooter from China. And now it's over to Smith of USA.
Oh.
Is this your final competition of the year?
Yeah. Yeah, now I have like a little break. And then maybe next year I'm going to shoot senior.
Really?
Yeah.
When's that decision made?
End of the year, or in January. So.
Because you are, no, I'm sure you do know your own age. How old are you?
I'm 19.
19? You feel old. Yeah, you were born in 1999, I see. In Hattam.
Hattam.
And somewhere else? Tulu? Is that Tulu?
Low,
not Tulu.
It's like a little place in a community.
Okay, whereabouts in Holland is this?
It's like 50 minutes from Hattem. That's where I live, near Zwolle. And it's like 1.5-2 hours from Amsterdam.
Yeah.
For people who don't know it.
And how did you get into shooting?
My dad's
the People's Republic of China, still only with one miss on a total of 13. We have Simonton of the United States on 12, Sun of China on 12,
and
Smith
since
of the United
then
States.
I never stopped.
Song
wow,
as
you went from karate
on
to,
11,
to skeet.
Yeah, to skeet shooting. Yeah,
was it always skeet? Went straight to skeet?
No, it was first feet task and some hunting targets and. But after 4 years, I met my coach, and she was like, oh, you're good. So then we came in touch, and I started shooting with her. And I was talented, so I made the talent team in Holland, and now I'm in the junior team Orange.
Going on senior, and with that junior European record as well, so it's working out pretty good, yeah?
Yeah, yeah. I have my contract with Beretta, so that's also pretty awesome. And I have an amazing gun.
I'm sure. But you mentioned that this is your last competition, I suppose. So you're rusty in time for next season. You've got to keep training throughout the winter.
Yeah, I keep training 3-4 times a week. But no competitions, maybe some in Germany that's nearby, or maybe in Holland, maybe a small competition, but not big competitions like this or other events.
So we're at station 4, and after this, we'll be back to station 5, where each athlete will have another 4 targets, 2 pairs each, and after that, our first elimination will be. This is squeaky bum time, some might say. The business end of the finals is where it starts to get serious.
Yeah, someone's going to fall off.
Yeah, and that someone probably isn't Zhou Yufei of China. 15 hits to her name.
I don't think so.
She's leading the way.
Yes,
the People's Republic
quite
of China
comfortable.
Still with only one miss on the
but
total.
But currently
of
in
15,
bottom spot and in that danger zone. As you can see now on the table is our Russian shooter, Eva Grabova, with 13 hits. That's the same as
station
Song,
five.
But we talked about bib number earlier. the Russian has got the weakest bid number out there, so that could be her downfall. Let's see, there's still four targets each.
Yeah, can happen a lot in four targets.
Yeah, you can never really feel safe, can you, in this sport? You could be leading the way, but a few misses.
Yeah, you can be out in no time.
And do you like the bib number scenario to deal with tiebreaks?
Personally, I like the old system better with the bronze and the gold medal match. But yeah, it's on the one side it's fair because everyone starts at zero, and the other side, if you're like coming in as first, you can also go out as at sixth place. So it has two sides, but it's not my word to say what to do. So
you can have an opinion, that's fine, but it certainly makes qualifying even more important than it all was. It's about getting in the finals. Getting in the final as well as you can, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, we've just had Jia Yufei shoot another four, so she's on to 19. She's safe.
She's safe. I think she's safe.
And this is Song, who's in a bit of a battle with the Russian shooter, but if she hits all four here, she'll be safe as well.
Yeah, she already had two, so.
So two more for safety. Gets him.
Yeah, she's going through.
So now it's our third Chinese shooter, Sun, who's on 14 hits, which is one more than the Russian in bottom spot.
I think she already knows.
So if she hits one more, she's safe for sure. So Evgrovova could be out before she even shoots.
Yeah.
If Sun hits here. She did hit one. So the best Evgrovova could get onto is 17, but Sun does have a better bib number. Smith now. Smith's on 14. So I guess she could hit all four and she's safe as well. Let's see what happens. Speculating here.
She missed one.
Okay. So she's on to 15. If she hits both of these, she'll still be safe. The bib number will keep her in. And she does. So whatever Evgrovova does here, if she hits all four, it won't be enough to keep her in.
Yep. But she did great.
Yeah, it's her first really world championship. She made it in. Did she get that?
Yeah.
Her above given?
Oh, that's good. It's good that the judge sees that there is a piece off. So.
There!
Well, she signs out, hitting all four there at station four. So a total of 17, the same total as two other
sixth position
athletes.
Representing the United States of America.
Four.
Please give it up.
The scoreboard.
I
think we're looking at an incorrect scoreboard.
We missed it, yeah.
So it's Shay Yufei who still leads.
So the scoreboard here was showing something different.
Out of 20.
So apologies to Russia.
Three.
You're still in. You're all good, but Samantha Simonton of the USA has left the competition in sixth place, which is, I suppose, a surprise because she came in the strongest with the better bib number.
Yeah, that's the part of this final. She came in as first and she goes out as sixth, so that's, I feel really sorry for her.
Yeah, she took the bronze medal a year ago at the World Championships in the junior final. And it's sixth place here in Changwon for Simonton.
But she's a really good shooter, so she might be proud of herself.
Yeah, but I'm sure, when you've had a taste of that medal from last time, I'm sure she'll feel disappointed right now, but it's up to the coach to sort of remind her how much of an achievement this is.
Yeah, it's great. I mean, sixth place as a world championship is awesome.
So, I don't know whether to believe that scoreboard now.
Yeah.
Look at the other one.
I have to look at the other one.
One miss for Song there.
No, two. Arathon. That board says two. No, you're the eyes on the scoreboard.
Oh. Yeah, I'm a, yeah. Yeah. I think we need a fresh pair of eyes. I think we both failed at looking at scoreboards. But it is very difficult because one is not updating as well as the other, and they're both obstructed by various things here. But anyway, two hits for Sun. And it's back to Austin Smith now. And the speed starts to pick up, doesn't it? Because obviously we've got less people out there. The eliminations keep on coming, don't they?
Yeah, every 10 targets one is going to fall off, so the rounds are going to be faster. And yeah, if you can keep your control and keep yourself calm, it's better. Because most, if you like go faster, you shoot faster. So.
Mm. There's some big cheers from the American team in the audience here. Do you like the kind of noise around you whilst you're out there shooting? By that I mean obviously the audience and the music. Do you find that helps your game, or do you find it distracting? Because I hear differing opinions.
No, I don't like it myself. But yeah, my coach always says if there falls a bomb next to you, you have to be shooting. So.
Wow.
Can't pay attention, but I find it annoying.
All right, so we're moving back to station four now for a cheeky double each. It is Gervais of China leading the way. Two hit lead now over Smith, who's in second place
on
bib number. And our Russian shooter still in this final is going well in third place, followed by Sun and then Song of China. Six targets now till our next elimination.
Yeah.
You're happy with that? Happy with what I said? You checked the scoreboard.
Yeah, I checked it.
It's all good.
I don't want to say anything wrong again.
Don't worry. If you say something wrong, I'll say something more wrong within a minute. So it's fine. I'll always out wrong you. Misses yet at station four.
Oh!
Chance. Son of number two, so perfect. Station for all three Chinese shooters who now have the highest bib numbers. Still, our Russian shooter with the weakest, then it's Smith. Gervais has the best bib number out there.
Yeah, she's really good.
Yeah, she's in a strong position, isn't she? Leading the way, obviously on hits, but also with that bib number as a backup as well.
There.
Two more hits for Evgenova. All right, so we are back now at station 25, and this is where fifth place will be decided. So there's no doubt about Gervais. 25 hits, also that better bib number. Smith and Grover still separated by bib number there, but from 23, and in that danger zone it is Song. He'll be the second of the Chinese shooters to shoot. She's got a better bib number than Song. What are you thinking? Do you think Song can get out of this one?
I don't know.
Thank you, Ed.
Yeah, I don't know. It's just, it depends on how they shoot the last targets. If you say they're going to go through and the other goes through, it's harsh. So.
Yeah, no, I agree with that. And it's a sport you can't predict anyway. And there's so much happening around us.
Like if you get like a wind from below or something and you miss, then
and also there's a little thing called pressure at play as well, and
at a world championship I would feel pressure.
So Song with two hits could really do with another two.
That's good.
She Jetson, so she's on 25, currently in second place, but Son's still got to shoot, as has Smith as well. Son hits all four, she's fine.
Yeah.
If. Big if, isn't it? And now that pressure. Halfway
still,
there.
Still two to go.
Ooh, okay. So that could be very costly for Son. She is one behind Song. She's ahead of Smith. But Smith's still got a shoot. Smith's only one behind. Yeah. And Smith's level
is already higher.
But she needs another one because Son has got a better bib number. Despite that, Smith's up into second place, despite that miss there. In our live table, which I think I trust.
I think Son has 24.
That's right, yes.
Yeah,
yes,
so
sorry,
Son,
not 20,
is, Son is
25, I thought. But yeah, 24,
Son is
you're
going
right.
Fall out.
Yep, yep, the Russian's already done enough to stay in. More than enough to stay in.
So Ekrovova, next so elimination from this final, finishing in fifth position, representing the People's Republic of China. Son Yushu
in this final. So we're down to two shooters from China left.
What a hotly contested final.
First
this
ever
is
world championship.
Still Shea Yufei, who
first
leads
year
on 29, only one miss so far.
Junior World Cup in Sydney.
Ekrovova of Russia Seoul. Up to second position. Smith of the United States in third
there.
And Song of
best
China
finish,
in
all competitions.
On 25. We're back at station
previously
three.
Previously was sixth in Sydney. But still at the top, Shea Yufei looking good. Still got that two-hit lead.
Yeah. Yeah, she's really good. She is in all the competitions I went to and she was there. She is been good. So.
Yeah, she's looking pretty comfortable. But like we said, things can change quickly. We're another 10 targets away from our next elimination and getting closer to those medal positions. So people say this is the position you don't want, fourth and seventh.
Oh, yeah, that's off. It's just like one or 2 points out of final if you become seventh. And if you're fourth, then you... Yeah, just missed her medal.
But so close to it. And something interesting here, because Shea Yufei has missed her first two.
Yeah, the other two are amazing.
But she's given the others a chance to close the gap. But yeah. She still has that better bib number.
Yeah, but also she was like 4 points in front of them, I think.
Was she four or two?
She now has 31 targets and... Song can get 29. Yeah.
Yeah, Song does move on to 29 as you predicted. So she's currently in second place, but
yeah,
got Smith now.
Oh! What again?
You sticking around for the men's skeet final afterwards?
Maybe. Maybe not.
And when do you go back home?
Yeah, this night.
Tonight?
4 a.m.
Oh, 4 a.m., okay. Yeah. That's a good one for Smith. Skeet men's final is at 4:30. So after this final, we'll be off just for a short while. Back again at 4:30. My colleague Shaq Thea will be guiding you through that final. One miss there for Ekrovova.
There.
Another miss. So she's
at the
on
top.
29.
She still leads, though, on a total of 31.
No change
just one
in terms of the leader, but the lead has
the
gone
United
down.
States
so it's
on
it's one, the difference.
Song of China
so it must
on
have been
29, along with
three her lead previously.
Oh, yeah.
We were debating.
Also
I thought two, you thought it was four. We were both wrong again.
She had a little buffer, so that was good.
And she's still got that slight buffer over Smith in second place. In the danger zone is Evgavova of Russia. Six away from our next elimination, that dreaded fourth place. But I say dreaded, you know, you're still fourth in the world championship. Best shooters in the world. So, a few wobbles from Cherna, who was going so well to begin with. Do you think that's simply down to nerves?
I think so, yeah. If you watch your scoreboard and you see yourself taking the lead, I think it would bring a lot of nerves.
John Smith. It's for her. So, important two targets now for the Russian shooter, Evgavova. She's on to 30. We go to station five to decide fourth place. So it is Jenny Faye still leading the way, but now she's leading on bib number. Smith is quarter in terms of hits total. They're both at 32, one more than Song. She's on one more than Evgavova. So it is the Russian shooter in that danger zone, one to make up. Then she still has the weakest bib number. So essentially two to make up, really.
Yeah.
But we're back with the leader. Two hits there. She'll be looking to settle down again, won't she?
Yeah, I think so. But she's still leading. So.
Three out of four. Song now. Takes her first two. And a second two. Smith, I think if she hits all four now, she could move into the lead.
Oh.
She hits three as well as Jay Face, so they will remain neck and neck on bib number. Also Song as well.
That
will be Evgavova. We'll leave the competition in fourth place. So she finishes on 32.
Fourth place is also really good.
Yep,
finishing
fourth place.
In position, representing
you know, you're amongst the best
Federation,
shooters you know, in the world. I'm sure, because you're so close to a medal at first, it must feel disappointing as an athlete
so
out there, but
close
it's going to sink
like
in that she's done really well. It's her first ever world championship, and her only previous international experience before this was the World Cup in Seoul. And look at this. Look at this for...
it's going to be exciting. Who's going to win? Who's going to take third place? Or
all neck and neck. And the thing we should say is that bib numbers still matter for now, for the next 10 targets anyway, for the bronze medal.
Only for the gold.
So as things stand, if it stayed the same way, Smith would take the bronze. And then when we get to gold, if we ever tie at the end, shoot off time, which you were hoping for. And you might get it the way this is going. She needed that, didn't she, after the last cycle, a few wobbles she had. So it's on to Song. China will get two medals from this final.
Yeah. But which ones?
We don't know. We're going to have to be patient and find out, aren't we?
It's a neck and neck race.
Have you ever gone up against any of like your teammates in a situation like this in a final? I mean, is it weird? My question would be, a follow up question would be, is it weird? But then do you just treat them like any other opponent?
You mean like from my
Dutch
team?
Yeah, have you gone up against a friend, like an actual friend from other teams, or a teammate from the Dutch team?
Well, I'm the only girl, so that's...
It's not happened then.
That's not really
but
possible.
Like, you know some of these shooters, you must go up against friends sometimes.
Yeah, if I like to shoot with Ashlyn, I don't know if you know from the Australian team.
Yes,
Ashlyn took the gold in the Sydney Junior World Cup. That's it. So before we came on air, and I said I commentated with a friend of yours, and I couldn't remember who it was Ashlyn.
Australia. Yeah. That's a really good friend of mine. And
have you competed against each other in a final?
Yeah, a few times.
Did it feel different?
No, because you're shooting for yourself. But you're also happy if the other one wins because you know how much they train and what they do for it. Just the same as you do. So, yeah, if she wins, I'm happy for her, and I know that if I win, she's happy for me. So
we are getting closer and closer to that bronze medal position being confirmed. Song going well there again. They've all been going well this cycle so far. She keeps the pressure on Smith. She hits them both, so she's still in third place based on bib number. There is nothing between these three athletes in terms of hit totals. All totals all on 41
per shooter for the bronze medal.
We're at station five now, four targets. So after this, the bronze medal will be decided. As things stand, it's going to Austin Smith of USA, but anything could happen, couldn't it?
Anything could happen. Every miss would be the end of the final for them.
Yep. It's essentially sudden death in a way.
Sort of. Off! Are about to change.
They're getting even more interesting out there now. I mean, if Song is a better bit more than almost double miss.
Oh my god. Oh, sorry.
That's okay. It's a dramatic moment.
Well, Shay Fay must be happy.
Yeah, almost let off the hook. Ooh. This has got to be nerves, hasn't it?
Yeah, I think so, because everyone is sending the same total.
But Smith has a real chance to
now,
stay
in
this. One miss, she's on 42 now. She's one, if I'm trusting that scoreboard, she's one behind Song. Trust it. Oh, so she's level, which means bib number does come into play. So if she hit those two, she would have stayed in. But still, nevertheless, it's the bronze medal for Austin Smith of the United States of America. You know, that's her second World Championships junior medals. So she took the silver in Moscow last year.
What a closely contested final this has
been. Year. So close there to staying in. And
Song also
still
on 43 for China.
World Championship bronze.
Shay
still
year.
Leading on 44 with six misses so
it's China
far.
Versus China essentially
so
now.
So the next 10 targets per shooter will decide the gold
Song
and silver
Jung
medals.
Ya. And there is one hit between them. And bib numbers, we've been talking about them a lot. Forget about them now, out of the window, because if, as we said before, if these two shooters end up tied in 10 targets time, they'll be exactly what Esme wanted, a shoot-off to settle it.
So exciting.
But you wouldn't say that if you were in it, would you?
No, I never. But if you're, like, watching, I mean, for everyone that's watching, a shoot-off would be, like, really exciting.
Yeah, yeah, for the spectator's point of view, it's good
awesome.
As it gets, isn't it?
Yeah.
But I guess it's nerve-wracking for the shooters involved.
So. She hit them all four.
Yeah, great start for Jie Yufei. If she keeps doing that, she'll take the gold medal. She's put just the pressure back on to Song. Needs to keep as close as she can. There's that one target difference previously between the two. That's two more, so it remains one target separating them with six remaining.
It's versus 47. Will we see a shoot-off in this final? Well, we'll find out.
Sounds
over
like
the next
Rory,
six
our announcer's hoping for a
shoot-off
as well. Teasing
the
crowd here in Changwon.
By one hit.
With a mere mention of it, and it is just that one hit, as we said. Here we go at station four. Jie Yufei. She is involved. She is the next four. She takes that gold medal.
Two targets now between Jie Yufei and Song on 48, and four targets remaining each. So it's in Jie Yufei's hands, and it feels like it's been in her hands.
Her destiny's been in her hands really since the start of this final.
Yeah, the whole final. She's taking the lead, and she deserves it also. So.
Yeah, well, she's still got some work to do now, but if she hits...
She has to hit three, I think.
Three will do it,
yeah.
Two of them. So she's on 52 now.
Just
53. So that's enough. And all exclusive, she has broken the junior world record as well. Vanessa Hokova of Slovakia. According to Seoul this year, 52. So it's not a bad day at the office, leaving a gold medal and a new junior world record. So there's Song Jungya finishing on 51, and she takes the silver. So it's a great day
so
for China. Gold and silver
now
on the podium.
Yufei,
there's
Jie
Yufei,
the People's
junior
Republic of China,
world
on a
champion,
total
and
of 53.
She's a new junior world record
also
holder.
Also, Song from the People's Republic of China on a total of 51. The
said,
silver
Song
medalist
Jungya,
and the bronze medal
China
going to the
silver
United States
and the
of America
medal.
To Austin
the United
Smith
States
on
of America
43.
With Austin Smith. So it was a... I mean, it ended how it started in terms of Jie Yufei being in top spot, but it wasn't as easy as that sounds, was it, for her?
No. She had a few misses, but she recovered really good and really strong, so she really deserves the gold medal.
Yeah, so how would you sum up this final then in just a sentence? Oh, two. I'll give you two if you need it.
Ooh. I don't actually know. just like really exciting.
It was exciting, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was exciting, so and I had nerves for them. Medalist,
the bronze medal representing
the United
States of America,
not really
Aston Smith.
But
no, that'll do. That'll do. That'll do. I can hear the excitement in your voice, and that's enough. So yes,
the
thank you for joining us at home. You can rewatch
the
final if you
China.
Want it.
Mr. Song
felt the excitement
Jockey.
Like Esme did here. It'll be on the ISF YouTube channel. We're also on Twitter, Instagram.
And the gold
there's
medalist
pictures,
and new world champion
clips,
and new junior
YouTube
world record of
Chinese social media
representing the People's Republic
nice
of China.
Fitting, considering the results this final, we're on Weibo and Youku as well. My guest, Esme van der Veen, thank you very much.
Thank
ladies
you
for joining me. Thank you very much for your attendance at this final.
Best of luck for next season.
Thank you so much.
Final
out there
yeah.
in
we'll follow
more finals
as soon as
and more
possible.
Records,
yeah.
etc. And also
I
keep
hope
hold
you can
of that
talk about
record.
Me instead of I'm sitting
to.
Here. Yeah.
If not, the second option's always available for you up here with
nice.
Me or my colleagues. So thank you, Esme, and thank you at home. And we're going to be back at 4:30 here in Changwon for the Skeet men's final. But until then, it's goodbye from us.
Look here when you okay, thank you very much.
This is the victory ceremony for the Skeet Women Junior Event.
Skeet 여자 주니어 종목 시상식입니다.
The medals will be presented by Mr. Hwang Yong-duk, President of the Korea Shooting Federation.
메달은 황용덕 대한사격연맹 회장님께서 시상하시겠습니다.
He is accompanied by Mr. Hong Chung-pyo, Vice President of the Korea Shooting Federation.
기념품은 홍정표 대한사격연맹 부회장님께서 시상하시겠습니다.
The bronze medal representing the United States of America goes to Austin Smith. Silver medal representing the People's Republic of China goes to Song Chongyi. And the gold medal representing the People's Republic of China, goes to Xie Yufa. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the People's Republic of China.
모두 자리에서 일어서 주십시오. 중국의 국가연주가 있겠습니다.
Ladies and gentlemen, we congratulate the winners of the Skeet Women Junior Event.
네, 큰 박수로 스킷 여자 주니어 종목의 메달 수상자들을 축하해 주시기 바랍니다.
We now take some photographs of the medal winners.
사진 촬영이 이루어지고 있습니다.